Our TEP team presents a Trespasser mod. Return to Jurassic Park. Hello, Mr. Nylund here. Welcome to Jurassic Park Trespasser. A game released in 1998, and this is a mod, the Return to Jurassic Park mod, but it's the old version named JPark in the folder. So the folder name and the files are named JPark. Okay, it's from 2013. So there are a bunch of different versions of this mod. So there are this version. And then there is a version from 2013-14 named RTGP 2013. I couldn't load it. It's the same as this one, but with bigger files. I believe the creator, TheIdiot, over at Trescom and modibe.com, I believe that he had added more items to it and maybe placed out more dinosaurs. But I couldn't load it in the actual game. There is a editor for the game that can load the files, however, so it's possible to look at the world and the map and the dinosaurs and such. But if I want to play it, it's not possible because it will crash to the desktop whenever I load it. However, I need to correct myself as I... In the previous video I made, where I recorded from the latest release, released in, I believe TheIdiot, the creator of this mod, that's his username, I believe that he released an unfinished version of the mod in June 2020, and that version I actually did preview in a previous video, but I couldn't load the helipad level. And I only could play on the testing level and on the prologue. But you couldn't really go that far in the prologue. It's an epic intro though. Same intro that I've added to this video. Okay, so this version, unlike that version, is very playable. Of course I couldn't leave this area. But whenever I used the TNX cheat code, I could move to other areas of this level, and after using it two times or three times, I ended up at the visitor center, and all the areas of the visitor center building have proper voice lines by the actors of the original game, the actor playing John Hammond, and then there were dinosaurs placed out, a T-Rex and raptors and such. That's why I'm playing this now, because I want to preview that. But in the version from 2020, you couldn't even load the helipad level, despite that level being said to be the most completed. However, I need to correct myself, because I managed to load it later, but I had to reduce the resolution. Couldn't load it at maximum graphics. I had to use really bad resolution to load it. The worse resolution I used, the less likely it was to crash. So it only crashed if I used maximum resolution or too good resolution. I believe everything above 1600 in resolution was too much. Okay. Then there are two other old versions. One version named RTEP 2013. Same version as this one, but with slightly bigger files. That version, unfortunately, couldn't be loaded. It's too big. Two big files didn't help lessening the resolution. And then the other version, the 2017-18 one, the one that TheIdiot played I believe a demo of in 2016, it worked, but it had an issue. So whenever I moved backwards like this from a certain area, it could crash. I believe you start at the waterfall and it looked great, where you also get up to four weapons. I believe if you edit the files, you may be able to carry four weapons, but in the original game you could only carry two at once. You click on E, the E button, to switch between your gear. You can have two weapons, but when you edit the files you can have up to four weapons, and I believe you start with four weapons there, so it's possible to have all of them on you. Okay, and then it's possible to carry all of them at once, and then they have limited ammunition, of course, and you could move and watch a lot of areas from the starting location, but there were no dinosaurs. However, when you use the TNEX cheat code, it will take you to the area of that demo, and he had actually placed out dinosaurs there. I believe the Dilophosaurus or whatever, the one spit the spitting dinosaur that killed Dennis Nedry in the first movie, the fat guy. Okay, so that dinosaur is available to be killed, and then there are some herbivores in different locations, and then I found one big carnivore as well. We'll take a look at the other versions too, but I started with this one because, unlike the others, this one has more dinosaurs placed out and more voice lines placed out and is more finished, even though it's the oldest version. While the 2013 version, I couldn't even start. Otherwise, I would have probably played that one because it's probably this one with more stuff. And then the 2017 to 18 version is different. He has remade the levels, so it didn't have any carnivores placed out at the visitor center of the first movie, and there were less voice lines to be heard. In this version, when you enter each room, you will hear a voice, but in that version, almost no voices, and the rooms were much more empty and such, so I believe it was less finished, but the terrain looked much better on the IR. So he had added a lot of plants and terrain, so it looked more beautiful but was less finished when it comes to being actually playable. The 2020 version looked the best. It has the most vegetation, the most plants, the most areas being beautiful and covered with stuff, but it also had some herbivores in certain areas, but didn't have any carnivores. It had all the locations of the level. It had I believe the plantation house, the visitor center, the safari zone, and some other areas, but no dinosaurs. I believe there were some herbivores, but no carnivores, and it's kind of boring when you have no weapons and no enemy dinosaurs to kill. Okay, but let's take a look at this now. So we'll pick up this gun. We'll have to crawl to reach it.
Okay,
So this the
plenty.
problem with this gun is that whenever we pick it up, it might end up in the wrong pointing in the wrong direction. If it points towards me, then I'm shooting myself. If it points to the side, I will shoot to the side. That's not a problem in the vanilla game. It's a problem of this mod in this version, that she picks it up in an odd stance. It's like it's in the wrong, it's pointing in the wrong direction. So it's been a while since I recorded. As usual, I'm not the best English speaker when I haven't spoken in a while. Okay, let's try and move off this box here. It was impossible. In the worst case, I will have to restart the level because I got stuck. We will have to restart. Yeah, I see. So sometimes it will bug out too when we can't restart it, because when I click restart, we will just end up in the same area. Let's quit to the main menu and new game and see if that will fix anything. No. But now I could move down. Let's pick up this instead.
Don't do this to
Some
me.
kind of old school mobile phone or
Hello?
whatever. I don't
Hello?
know what it is, but she's trying to speak to someone. Okay, we don't need that, but we need the gun. Problem is, it's pointing at the wrong direction. I wanted it to point differently. I want to pick up the gun, but I don't want it to point towards me. See, it's kind of glitched. It won't actually fire at the enemy now. We'll need to stand very weird for it to fire at the enemy. Let's place it on my back using the E button. It's still pointing wrongly. Let's try to drop it again. Try to pick it up from a different angle. That's almost good. We need to pick it up from this angle. Now it's good. If I now point it towards an enemy, it will shoot at the enemy. But as you see, this version has a glitch with the gun. She isn't holding it correctly. Okay, we need to click Ctrl F11 to use codes. We can also enable the gore 2 sheet so we get more blood, etc. And then we will enable the T next sheet, which will it will transport us to other areas. By the way, this is using the Trespasser custom engine, the TCE as it's known. Okay, this means that we are using a custom engine required for this mod in order to use the fly sheet code that enables us to fly over the map. We will need to use the ATX engine instead, but the problem is that the ATX engine it doesn't work with this mod. Okay. And I believe the idiot, the creator of the mod, forgot that. But now I believe it kinda got stuck. That wasn't good. Let's see here. T next again. Hello, we're back inside of the game. So it can crash, but I managed to play for quite a bit and it didn't crash. And it didn't crash, but sometimes it crashed CDs or crashed the desktop immediately. And other times I can play quite a lot without it crashing. So we started at the area of the visitor center. This is the visitor center of the first Jurassic Park movie. Let's click on options, audio, and move this back a bit. It's too high, too loud. So you can move in the water. It's beautiful. There's a T-Rex over there that we do not want to meet. So this is the visitor center. Let's move to the other side first. If it's CTD, we will just restart it and start again at that location. I've saved it at the opposite side of the entrance to the visitor center. So if it's CTD, we will just load that save. So we have a car over there. I don't know if we want to trigger the Rex yet. We can move to this side instead. You can see the terrain is less beautiful here compared to in later versions, but it's still very impressive. So this version is using the entire Isla Nublar world map, so it's the entire island, but I believe there are some dead ends, so you can't go to every area by foot. You need a fly sheet, and it doesn't work with the Trespasser CE or custom engine. So I believe it's impossible to reach all the areas of this map with this engine. Okay, but we can still play on quite a large area here. And unlike later versions, this version has a gate over there that we can check out. There's some signs here too. I believe this area over here was removed in later versions. Have a gun. She's now holding it the wrong way again. That's an issue with this mod only. I've not seen it in any other mod or in the official game. So now she's holding it correctly. I wanted to point forwards in case we are facing a raptor or something. Or another dinosaur. I believe the T-Rex can't be killed unless we have a bazooka or something. But any other dinosaur. Oh shit! Run! Shit! That dinosaur showed up from nowhere. I expected it to be on the other side of the fence, like the last time I played. I didn't expect it to be there. Whew. I didn't expect it to be right behind me. So I dropped the gun. Now I need to pick it up from the right angle too. So if the dinosaur moves into me, then I will drop the gun automatically. Same thing happens if we are like walking into an object. That will often result in losing the gun. So there we have a Velociraptor. So I need my gun. But I don't want that raptor to be too close. Okay, so this is Return to Jurassic Park, a Trespasser mod. And the JPark version of it. The files are from 2013, as I said. So it's the oldest available version, but still the most playable version. The only one with dinosaurs in this location. And the only one with this gate here, with the raptor close to it. Shit. Question is, where is my gun? Right there beside the raptor. It's right there in the middle of the road. And I want it back. I don't have a use for it against the T-Rex, but I could kill the raptor with it. Her arm is slightly bugged. Wonder if it will attack me. Move too close. Or if it's friendly, I don't know. I was surprised I didn't die last time. Seems to only be able to move this way. Not good that it's moving right at the spot where my gun is. It's not good at all. Actually, we might want to load. It's annoying to do anything about the raptor. Okay, let's drop it. So now we have a gun pointing forward, perfect.
Now we're getting somewhere.
I will kill that raptor. beautiful sight. I believe when we reach that area with the car over there and the door, then the T-Rex will automatically come for us. I don't want to trigger the T-Rex right now. Here we have a spot inside of the building.
Nothing here. Bet you Hammond's the one who's got all the fun satellite phones.
Right. We'll check the rest of the building later. Nothing here indeed. Need that raptor to die. Unless it's friendly. We will see. What does this sign say? Visitor center over there, yeah. I believe the raptor is in this forest. Or in the other one. Let's move into the forest. By the way, we can pause the game. Audio could be moved up a bit. More interesting when we hear the sound when she walks and the terrain sound. Oh, we have a fence here. Where is the raptor? Don't like being surprised. Like the last time. Oh, we dropped the gun. Exactly what I didn't want. Let's place it in the back so we won't drop it. When we move into objects, we will also drop the gun if we are holding it. Can't see the raptor. Weird. It on this side. I don't want to be surprised. Didn't like that sound. It sounded like the earth was shaking. I don't want to be surprised by some T-Rex or something. Let's move down here. Take a look at this area. We have some buildings over there. Maybe some raptor areas or whatever. All level is still very beautiful, still very impressive. Of course the new levels have a lot of more what should I say, high resolution textures and more objects and such, but too many objects and the game can't load, or it's very likely to crash. That's why I believe this one is more playable. It worries me that they have no raptor here. Might just show up out of nowhere like last time. There's a door there we can enter. I believe the raptor came from there. The last time it had already entered this area. Why does it sound like a T-Rex is moving or something? Holy crap, a brachiosaurus. Over here. Let's go there. So we have a brachiosaurus over here. So I have never played this level to the fullest extent. I have only played very little of it, checked it out yesterday. Checked out all the levels. I wanted to play one of the more recent, but I found that this was more playable. Okay, and even if the 2017 version was playable to some extent and had some dinosaurs, it still had way too few dinosaurs. This one seems to be almost ready. But yeah, the locations are much more bare bones compared to the later versions. Much more green. What should I say? Empty areas here. The latest version has a lot of cool stuff. Oh, a hostile little dinosaur there. The small ones from the Lost World movie. I believe it's a hostile one. It's probably not dangerous to the Brachiosaurus, but I believe it could be dangerous to us. Could follow it and see if it's hostile. This little thing. I don't know. I believe it's a carnivore. It doesn't seem to be hungry. Or it's trying to attack the Brachiosaurus. Yeah, it's trying to attack the Brachiosaurus. Or me. I believe it's attacking the giant dinosaur, and that's why it's failing, because it can't hurt it. I believe this one is almost as indestructible as the T-Rex. You need a bazooka or something to take it out. But yeah, it's a carnivore, it could kill me. But it's busy trying to kill that Brachiosaurus, fortunately. Let's try to jump away from it. Oh, it's two of them here, I saw another one. I don't like that. We will move away from here. We'll move away. Don't want to face small carnivores if I don't have to. So I've never been here before in this version. In other versions I've actually moved to that area over there. But I faced no dinosaurs on the way there. I believe in this version we might actually face hostile creatures. Oh, I can't move there. I believe we can't jump up there. We need to fly. Okay, we need to move back. So in the ATX engine there is a bunch of new cheat codes. One of the cheat codes is the fly cheat. But the Trespasser CE or custom engine can't use that code. There is no sheet. There is no fly sheet on this engine. So we can't really go to areas that have no bridge, etc. I believe the idiot, the creator of the mod, forgot that because he said you should use the fly sheet when playing the game, while at the same time saying you can only play the game with the CE engine. So that's impossible. Because the fly sheet doesn't work with this engine. Okay. So the raptor should be here somewhere. I don't like surprises. Oh, there's the raptor. It might have spawned. Spawned when we moved on the road. Spawned behind us. That's a scary thing. I believe some mods actually make dinosaurs spawn when you get close to the areas. They aren't in the game before you go to a certain point. Allowing for some surprises. Hey. It looked hostile there. Like it tried to attack. They seem to... Shit! Run for your life! So in the latest version of this mod, you can't jump too much. Yes, it made it impossible to jump more than like 3 times at once. But in this version you can jump unlimited times, just like in the original game. So when you jump, you can escape from any dinosaur. You jump faster than you run. So on S you walk like this. This is walking. Then on V, the common button, you run. And this is much faster. But you can't run faster than the dinosaurs, at least not in the original game. I believe you run faster now than in the original game too. But when you jump, it's even more... I believe when you jump, they can't catch you, and when you run, they can. But in this mod, I think you run way faster than in the vanilla game, so you might be able to run away from dinosaurs too. That's not possible in the vanilla game, or in most mods. So we hurt the Velociraptor by shooting it, but unfortunately we missed most of the time, and it survived. And now it's probably healed again. It will heal after a while. Okay, and it's hostile. It will kill me if I move too close. And I won't heal either. I'm still almost dead. You see the heart there. When it's fully red, we will die. So one more bite and we are dead. Okay. If we die, we will just load the save. It would be interesting to move past the raptor. Kinda boring that it just walks that in that small area too. I believe in certain mods they will follow you for very far distances, but in this mod it won't move much. Oh, the Brachiosaurus has reached all the way over here. So it's possible for the Brachiosaurus to go here. That's cool. That makes me worried that the smaller dinosaurs, I don't know their names, they can also move to this area. Because they hunted this Brachiosaur. So they might actually want to hunt it all the way here. And if I'm bitten one more time, I'm dead. Okay. But this thing cannot move here. That's cool. Maybe it can move to the water. Why is it moving backwards like that? Maybe it's moving into some trees or something. Have trouble moving. Oh, it's reached the road. I would like to see that dinosaur facing off against the Tyrannosaurus. It would have been fun to have the Velociraptor follow me all the way into the visitor center, but... and unlike the T-Rex, the smaller carnivores actually usually will follow you for far distances. But unfortunately, this one won't. It will only run around in that area. Now it ran into the forest. Okay, so it will only move in that small area. And that's a little disappointing. More fun if it will hunt me all the way into the visitor center like in the movie. Okay. But Brachiosaurus has reached all the way over here. That's impressive. In the vanilla game you will be healed after a while if you have stayed out of trouble, but in this game we won't. I don't know how we will heal. So in one mod we could heal by going into the water and drinking or something, but in this game, I believe that may have been one of the later versions of this game mod actually. I don't know if that's possible here. I would like to be healed. I don't like being that damaged. Okay, also the dinosaurs of this mode have a problem, and that's the fact that if you're too far away, they will just stop moving. That's an issue with, I believe, their Return to Jurassic Park mods, that they won't move if you are too far away. While in the vanilla game and in Dark Secrets and others, they will move no matter where we are. Maybe they will move, it just stood still, but in some mods they won't even move if we are too far away. I believe that's due to some setting in the files. Could try to jump past it, the Velociraptor. Oh, the raptor has moved all the way over here. I wonder if the raptor could attack the Brachiosaurus. It's probably too big for it to be able to kill it. But it would probably attack it if the Brachiosaurus moved close enough. Okay. Let's trigger the T-Rex. Should we move into the visitor center first, maybe? Yeah, I think we'll take a look at the visitor center first. We'll move into the center. So this is the area of the first movie. At the end, when they escaped, and the T-Rex killed the Velociraptors. Here we have the skeleton of the dead T-Rex in the center.
Hello? Hello?
All gone home.
Dinosaurs and the earth. There are a lot of rooms here, and I believe there are voice lines in every room, unlike in later versions. That's why this visitor center is more interesting to visit. Here we have some boxes.
Where's the goddamn phone? I want out of here. I want diet soda. I want copy machines and juice boxes and cartoons.
Ingen reception. I planned that someday visitors, scientists and politicians would be welcome here.
Staff only. Just gonna move up some stairs here to reach this area. Look down there. I think we'll move back. Nothing to see here. Dead end over here. Here too. Dead end. So not everything was complete. But I still think this has more areas with voice lines than the other versions. Also this visitor center seems bigger than the others, but the others seems more detailed. In the latest one, from 2020, you could even move up the stairs. You can't in this one. We have some dinosaurs on paintings. Oh, we have some kitchen here. Kitchen. You can move the chairs. Can even touch them and move them, but we couldn't lift them up. We can probably walk on them too. Try. Yeah, we can walk on the table. Here we have a scene. The door. An empty room. Yeah, not every room was finished. I believe they are slightly more colored in the other version, but in this version I believe there were more interesting locations to see. Here we have an outer area, less gigantic, it states. Cool. Need to jump up on the tables to move. Trying to jump up this table. Could probably push that chair down. Could move down here. Cool little outdoor area. I'll try to push down the chair. Yeah, it was possible. Cool. This area isn't finished in the later versions. So the outdoor area is much more impressive here. Okay. Oh, but fuck! Fuck! A raptor on the tables. Jesus, where the fuck did it come from? Didn't see that one coming. If I jump down, it will probably just jump down after me. So I need to reach that door. But the raptor is in the way. Will come for me. Fuck, this could go wrong. I'm dead, I think. One bite and I'm dead. We'll have to replay this. This didn't happen last time, but I never was in this area. I believe that raptor spawned. It spawned, I'm pretty sure. Jesus Christ, it really wants to kill me. I have no weapons. I'm unarmed. That's pretty cool that he managed to make it spawn here. However, in the Dark Secrets mod, the modders, by using the ATX engine, he managed to make dinosaurs drink and jump and such. The raptors there can jump. So in the original game, they were supposed to have a bunch of different emotions. I said that in the last video, but they, in the end, all the enemies only have one emotion, kill the player. And the friendly motions and the jumping stuff, etc. We are disabled. Shit, we are almost dead now. We're dead. Oh, fuck. He got me. Okay, so the dinosaurs have one emotion, kill the player if they're carnivores, and now it's eating on me. Okay, pretty cool that it spawned inside of this area too. We need some of move here again, but managed to get back into the house. The raptor following us. Okay, what I was saying was that the ATX engine re-enabled some of the emotions that got cancelled. Oh, the raptor fell down on the ground below. Okay, but what I was saying was that the ATX engine re-enabled some of the cancelled features of the game. And one of those features were that the raptors could actually jump. A very cool feature. Oh, we fell down on the ground too now. It will probably find me and start to eat again. Okay, so the raptors can jump in the Dark Secrets mod and in any mod using the ATX engine. This mod was originally based on the ATX engine too, but the difference is that the ATX engine is loading levels. They are like one file that the engine loads, while I believe the CE engine can load an entire folder full with different files. I didn't manage to load this mod in the ATX engine, but in the CE engine it worked. and unfortunately the CE engine is worse than the ATX engine in the sense that it doesn't have those new cheat codes, and it does like fly, and so you can't fly, and also it doesn't have the new animations or the re-enabled or re-implemented animations. For example, the Raptor's ability to jump. It would be pretty cool if it actually jumped and attacked the player. I found me and started to eat again. Okay, so the Raptors would have been able to jump if we had used that engine instead, but I couldn't load the mod in that engine, so that sucked. Okay, and then the other thing is that all the dinosaurs can move inside of buildings in that engine, but in this one they can't. But I believe this Raptor spawned when I was in that area, it just showed up from nowhere. Okay, so that's pretty cool that the Raptor was inside. Let's load the save game. Okay, so now we know. I thought the... Ah, fuck it, crashed. See you inside the game.